baseball yesterday. How about them Cubs? They finally snapped a three-game losing streak. It was long for them, the longest they've had of the season. It's
time. Basketball, football, baseball, they're all the greatest. Chicago, it's the greatest sports city in the country, the world. This place is buzzing year-round. The fans, the teams, everything to do with sports, they're all behind them 100%.
My life has been a continuous journey of being connected to these wonderful people in Chicago.
Believe it, the dream is reality. The Chicago Bears are world champions of football.
To be a champion in this town, it's the greatest feeling in the world. As far as I'm concerned, I'm still a champion in this town, and it happened almost 20 years ago.
Jordan.
We built a dynasty in this town. Six NBA titles. Now the world's greatest golfers are here to be named the next champion. It's their turn to do something great.
Their turn in America's championship. To join the pantheon of this city's rich sports history. The U.S. Open has come back to Chicago, to Olympia Fields, the latest stop in time on a magical 103-year journey.
The Open Championship of the United States of America.
Little Ben Hogan captures top honors today.
The most sensational rally in Open golf history.
There it is, a three-shot victory.
Their turn to do something great. Their turn to harness this championship's incomparable surges of emotion. Their turn to seize it, cherish it, believe in it, and make it happen.
Payne Stewart is the 1999 U.S. Open champion.
The 100th U.S. Open champion in history. And his second U.S. Open championship. He is now the people's champion.
The 103rd U.S. Open.
The 103rd United States Open.
103rd U.S. Open. Welcome to Chicago.
Hi, everybody. I'm Dan Hicks, and we welcome you to the 103rd United States Open Championship from Olympia Fields Country Club just south of Chicago. This marks the 13th time that the national championship has been staged here in the Chicago area and the first time in 75 years that it's been held here at Olympia Fields. Back in 1928, Johnny Farrell defeated the great Bobby Jones in an epic first-ever 36-hole Open playoff. The questions that pervaded in this championship before it began was, could the world's top-ranked player, Tiger Woods, win this championship for the third time in the last 4 years, and in the process, become just the second player in more than half a century to win back-to-back U.S. Opens? The U.S. Open has long been considered the most challenging test in all of golf. For the 103rd time, the world's best golfers would vie for the championship. This layout was located 25 miles south of downtown Chicago and designed by former British Open champion Willie Park Jr. back in 1923. The par 70, near 7,200-yard layout, yielded some great scores and shots early on. But it was Justin Leonard who set the pace early in the first round, his second birdie in a row at the third to get to 2 under. Another birdie try at the ninth.
the former U.S. amateur champion, was out in 34. A pitching wedge approach shot to the 13th set up yet another birdie, as did this 8-iron on the very next hole. Now at 15 for his third straight birdie. And Leonard with his lowest U.S. Open round of 4-under par 66. As expected at an Open, a few unexpected names popped up on the leaderboard. 44-year-old journeyman J. Don Blake had made only 2 of 10 cuts so far this year, but a birdie at 6 got him to 2-under. Then, Blake's 7-iron approach shot at the par 4 8th. He would make that to get to 3-under. After a bogey at the 9th, this laser-like approach with a 5-iron on the par 4 10th would get him back to 3-under. And the one-time tour winner would end with a 66, sharing the clubhouse lead with Leonard in the morning. Another unlikely contender was 33-year-old Brett Quigley. His second shot to the par 4 13th. That would end up his second of 3 birdies in a row. Now his approach to the par 4 16th. Quigley was making it look easy, and he would make that to take the outright lead at 5-under. The Massachusetts native for par at 18.
There it is, what a round for Quigley.
Man, he made everything.
Just his 5th round in the Open, but still his best score by 6 shots. And it's only the 7th 65 or better in the first round of a U.S. Open.
Some of the game's biggest names, however, were not taking advantage of the soft conditions at Olympia Fields. Last year's runner-up Phil Mickelson still looking for his first major in this, his 44th major start, for par at 17. And that miss would result in his third bogey in his first 8 holes. He struggled all day on the greens, taking 31 putts in his first round, still an opening round of 70 for the world's 6th-ranked player, just 5 back. Another star yet to win a major in 47 tries, Scotland's Colin Montgomery did get off to a quick start on his opening 9. A second straight birdie on the 13th. In trouble at the 3rd, this is 3rd shot on this par 4. A par save there, but 2 bogeys in his last 4 holes resulted in a 69 for Monty. 2-time U.S. Open champion Ernie Els was a model of consistency in the opening round. The approach shot at 14 for the world's 2nd-ranked player. And that would get him to 1-under. Even with superb iron shots like this one at the 3rd, Els made only 1 birdie on the day and 17 pars for an opening round of 69. Playing alongside the reigning British Open champion was last year's champion, Tiger Woods, who began the week at Olympia Fields with great expectations. His morning would begin at the 10th. And the theme for Tiger Woods was missed birdie opportunities. As the world number one would start out with 8 pars in a row. Before he got to the 18th, his 9th hole of the day, for par there. Woods' lone bogey on his opening 9, and he was out in 1 over 35. Tiger struggled off the tee all day, hitting just 6 of 14 fairways in the first round. His day, though, was salvaged at the par 5 6th. This second shot from 256 yards with a 3-iron. Tiger would reach it in 2, make his eagle, and get into red figures. However, he bogeyed his last hole for an even par 70. The real emotion of the day would come from another Stanford University golf product, 53-year-old Tom Watson. The 1982 champion at Pebble Beach, Watson was playing in his 30th U.S. Open championship on a special exemption.
After starting at the 10th with a bogey, this 170-yard approach shot with a 6-iron to the par 4 12th. A spectacular eagle to get into red figures. Coming off birdie at 16, his tee shot at the 17th, one of the longest par 3s in U.S. Open history. He would make par and out in 32. Now for a birdie at the first.
Just touches it.
And Watson's gonna move to 3 under.
Wow.
That's pretty darn good stuff there at 53 years old.
Yep.
And this day was special for more than just Watson and his fans. Bruce Edwards, his caddy and friend for the last 30 years, was with him every step of the way. It had been less than 5 months since Edwards was diagnosed with ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease. And while no one knew how many more events he would be able to caddy, there was no doubt that this was special for the longtime duo.
It was an emotional day for me because I love him so much. And everything he's done for me has been pretty special. And to see him out there looking and playing like he's 28 really warmed my heart.
The magic of the day was no more apparent than when Watson stroked his birdie putt at 7.
Can't stop there. Gravity has got to.
Hey, there you go.
How about that?
Then on the next hole, another birdie opportunity.
For the lead.
Yes. Man. That would have gone defended. Right in the middle. It
means a lot because I don't know if I'll ever be back in the U.S. Open again. I guarantee you, knowing him, he was doing it for me. That makes him a hell of a guy, in my book.
Two friends who, for at least one more day, could forget about the uncertainty of the road ahead and instead live one more memorable moment. Watson still had some work left, working from the bunker at the par 4 ninth. A par save there would give him a 5-under par 65, equaling his lowest round ever in a U.S. Open. But his longtime friend left the course with far more. Yet another cherished memory to carry with him forever. Watson and Quigley tied for the first round lead at 5-under. And at age 53, Watson became the oldest player ever to lead after any round of the U.S. Open. The wind died down for Friday's second round, and Olympia Fields was even more vulnerable to attack. Conditions were prime for low scores, and anyone who wanted to play during the weekend had to make their presence felt today. After his magical performance on day one, Tom Watson would have less than 13 hours to regroup for another round at Olympia Fields, the same course where he made his first PGA Tour start ever as an 18-year-old amateur in the 68 Western Open. Watson for birdie on the opening hole. After just 23 putts in the first round, the eight-time major champion would find the going tougher in round two, 34 putts on Friday, at the 12th for bogey. A double bogey on the hole he eagled a day earlier. Watson would finish with a 72, 3-under for the championship. The man he shared the first round lead with wasn't faring much better. Brett Quigley started his second round at the 10th at 7 a.m., and right away a bogey would drop him from the lead. His third shot at the par 5 sixth. He would fail to convert that birdie putt, only one birdie on the day for Quigley. Then for par at the eighth, and he would finish with back-to-back bogeys and a 74. Three-time major champion Nick Price was still eyeing his first U.S. Open title, and he quickly moved up the leaderboard early in round two. The 6-iron approach shot on the par 4 tenth. And that would set up his fourth birdie of the day to move to 3-under. At the 11th, a beautiful sand save. And Price, at age 46, was trying to rewrite the record books himself and become the oldest U.S. Open champion in history. After a bogey at 12, he had this birdie try at the 13th. Price to 3-under. And trying to make it two in a row at 14. Price with a 5-under par 65, matching the low score of the championship. Jim Furyk, along with caddy Mike Cowan, was also making a run up the leaderboard. Furyk opened with a 67, and birdies at the first and sixth got him to 5-under par midway through his second round. Furyk has 7 PGA Tour wins, but was still in search of his first major. This birdie putt on 13 to retake the outright lead. And Furyk moved to 6-under. He was looking for another birdie at the 14th. Furyk at 7-under. And now his approach shot to the 18th. Furyk hit every green in regulation but one in his second round. He would have a crack at his fifth birdie of the day against no bogeys. Despite the miss, still a 66 for Furyk, the championship leader at 7-under. Tiger Woods started the day just 5 off the lead. His tee shot on the longest opening hole in U.S. Open history. And for Tiger Woods, it was another missed fairway. But he scrambled on the first and had a birdie putt to move to 1-under. And then he had a long birdie attempt at the par 3 fourth. And the defending champion was on a roll. His approach shot at the fifth. His ball would take 30 seconds before it finally stopped rolling down the slope. He would fail to get it up and down and drop a shot. Tiger's second at the par 5 sixth from 247 yards with a 3-wood.
Oh, it's not a cut. That's a slice. And it's a good one, too.
Tiger would make birdie at the sixth and now lined up his approach at the 496-yard ninth, the second longest par four in U.S. Open history. This six iron from 202 yards, another birdie, and he was to three under. For par at the 11th. And that would result in his second bogey of the day. But he would birdie 13 and have this approach to the 16th. Tiger would make that for his sixth birdie of the day. The 27-year-old, already with eight major titles and eight USGA titles, is back in the hunt. His third at the last. A beautiful touch, and Woods finishes with a 66 in four under and just three out of the lead. In the threesome behind Woods that afternoon was world number four, Vijay Singh. After an opening round 70, Singh got off to a sizzling start. A chip in for eagle at the first. After going birdie bogey on two and three, Singh for another birdie at the fourth. Quickly to three under. Out in 34, but it was on the back nine where the 40-year-old from Fiji would write his name into the U.S. Open record books. After a birdie at 10, this putt for another at 11. The two-time major champion now four under par in his round. Now for birdie at 13. To five under. Singh's approach at the par 4 14th with an 8-iron. And Singh would set up yet another birdie. But as he was beginning to envision a magical 63 or lower, he was reminded of some controversial comments a month earlier.
Hey, BJ, I think Anakin's gonna put it in.
Just a few moments ago, as Vijay Singh was playing the 14th, that man right there was ejected from the golf course for firing some comments Vijay Singh's way. He's happy to see the man leave.
Talk about composure. Singh with this putt to go to six under. And he was continuing to light up the back nine at Olympia Fields. And all of a sudden, Vijay Singh was in reach of an historic number. The lowest round in the U.S. Open was 63, first shot by Johnny Miller in the final round of his win at Oakmont 30 years ago. It had since been matched by only two men, Jack Nicklaus and Tom Weisskopf in 1980 at Baltusrol. On the par 3 15th, he would have a chance for his third birdie in a row. Singh to 7 under par in his round and tied for the lead. After parring the 16th, his tee shot at the monster 261 yard par 3 17th.
Vijay Singh off the tee at 17. With a 3 iron.
What a round.
We said this was not a likely birdie hole.
Forget about it.
There were now visions of a 62 for Singh. But a missed opportunity there. No player in the history of the game has ever shot lower than a 63 in any round of a major championship. Singh would head to the final hole with a chance. A par would give him a share of the record, but a birdie would make it his own.
Oh, yeah. Right.
but his tee shot found the fairway bunker.
Cut, did it.
Now his approach. He was trying to become the 21st player ever to shoot 63 in a major, and the second player to do it twice, as Singh had shot the number before in the 93 PGA Championship at Inverness. This putt, though, for the magical 62. It wasn't to be, but Singh would tap in for par and a 7-under 63, equaling the lowest round in 103 planes of the U.S. Open. The round, including a record-tying 9-hole score of 29 coming in. Still, the heckler on 14 was a main topic in the media center, but Vijay was having none of that.
Vijay, you were very obviously heckled today at 14 green. Could you walk us through what happened there? And is that typical of the way some of the fans here are reacting to you and some of the things you've said about Annika Sorenstam?
Well, I hit a good tee shot on 14 and hit an 8-iron and made the putt and went to the next hole. I didn't notice anything.
As they were taking the guy out, you waved your putter at him.
I was waving to my caddy.
Waving to your caddy?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
It was a record Friday at Olympia Fields. Co-leaders Furyk and Singh both set new U.S. Open records for low 36 holes at 7 under par. A record low 36-hole cut was also established, and several notables were claimed, including Davis Love III, a winner three times already on the PGA Tour in 2003. David Duvall's struggles continued. The former world number one shot 78 and 72. Reigning PGA champion Rich Beem also missed the cut. He was 10 over after rounds of 74 and 76. 49-year-old Jay Haas, off to a great start at 10th on the money list, wouldn't play the weekend, and either would Haas's 21-year-old son Bill. It was only the sixth time ever that a father and son had competed in the same U.S. Open. And 16-year-old Tom Glissmeyer from Colorado Springs, Colorado, went home on a joyous note with a birdie on his final hole of the second round. The youngest competitor in the field had rounds of 80 and 79. The leaders were poised for round three of the 103rd U.S. Open, America's Golf Championship. And through 36 holes at Olympia Fields, the leaderboard was full of red numbers. But those who've enjoyed success thus far know it's only half over. Tiger Woods was in position to pounce on his third U.S. Open championship, his third title in 5 years, and continue his march into history. Yet there were others emerging with major credentials of their own who had yet to win an Open, including Justin Leonard and 46-year-old Nick Price. And Vijay Singh, coming off his historic round on Friday. Jim Furyk has enjoyed success on the PGA Tour, but never on a major stage. Then the sentimental choice, 53-year-old Tom Watson, winner of 8 major championships, who won his only U.S. Open title 21 years ago. The 103rd U.S. Open continued just outside Chicago. And Nick Price wasted no time making an early statement with this birdie at the first.
And the Price is in. Gets it to 5-under.
Then, this pitching wedge approach at the second. And he would make that putt for his second birdie. He had another birdie attempt at the third.
There it is, Nick Price. Birdie, birdie, birdie start to 7-under par.
Price taking aim with an 8-iron at the 159-yard par 3 fourth. And he would have that putt to get into the lead.
Four low for Price.
his second now at the par 5 sixth, a 5-iron from 224 yards.
Shaped it perfectly, landed it short. Look at this shot.
Price with two putt from there for his fifth birdie in the first six holes and the outright lead at 9-under. But he would encounter some problems in the meat of the golf course. A bogey at the seventh and another here at the ninth dropped him to 7-under. Price recorded three more bogeys on the back nine before this 8-iron approach shot to 18.
Second shot at 18 on the way for Nick Price. This guy could use a birdie right now, and maybe he's gonna get it. Nick!
Price for a 69. It would be his first birdie since the sixth hole. But at 5-under par, he was still in position for a Sunday charge. Price's playing competitor was first-round co-leader Tom Watson, who had an up-and-down day of his own at the first for birdie. Watson's putter just couldn't keep up with the torrid pace of Thursday. A bogey at the eighth, and he was back to 1-under. But a few magical strokes were still left for birdie at the par 3 15th. It would be his first and only birdie of the round, as Watson would shoot a 75 in the third round, two over for the championship. Olympia Fields wasn't playing as easy as it did the previous round. But as Tiger Woods began his round, obstacles remained abundant.
Wow, was there noise in that backswing?
Somebody whistled.
Boy, that is not good either.
Right on the top of his backswing, right on the start down, just whistled.
Now Tiger's third at the opening par 5.
Sounded good.
Boy, this is a good shot from there.
That's the guy who whistled on purpose. In your face, Whistler.
Woods still had a chance for an opening birdie. Not the start, though, he had hoped for on a par 5. And it only got more difficult at the par 4 fifth.
Oh, no.
Tiger's over the green, and it would be a difficult up and down on the third toughest hole of the week, as Tiger had this putt for par. He was back to 3-under. Another par putt at the ninth. And Tiger is out in 2-over 38. After a bogey at the 10th, Tiger would drop another shot here at the 13th. 4-over on his round. On the next hole, though, but he couldn't build any momentum to finish his round, his fifth bogey of the day on the 15th. He would also bogey 16 and finish with a 75, his highest round ever in the US Open as a professional. Instead of Tiger Woods, it was unheralded Australian Stephen Leaney who mounted a charge. The world's number 55th ranked player had made birdies at the first and fifth before this 9-iron approach shot to the ninth. Birdie number 3 for Leaney, and the 34-year-old from Perth was to 8-under par, just one off the lead. But Leaney double bogeyed the 10th and missed that short putt for par at 11, and he was back to 5-under. At 15, he had another birdie try. And he was back to 6 under. His second shot now at 18 with a 7 iron. That would set up his second birdie in the final four holes. A 68 for Leaney, in at 7 under. Leaney had been playing with Jonathan Bird on Saturday. The 25-year-old, who was the PGA Tour's Rookie of the Year in 2002, had a chance to get it to 6 under with this long birdie putt at the second. He would shoot a plus 171 to finish at 4 under after 54 holes. And there were some others making noise. Canadian Ian Leggett for eagle at the 6th. One of 13 eagles at the 6th for the week. It helped propel Leggett to a third round 68, 4 under for the championship. 33-year-old Alabama native Dickie Pride from the bunker at number 7. He had the round of the day on Saturday, a 4 under 66. It was the only bogey-free round of the day and jumped him into a tie for 4th. Playing with Tiger Woods was 48-year-old Argentinian Eduardo Romero. This long birdie try at 17. That moved him to 4 under. And on this day, the man nicknamed the Cat would better Tiger. Romero with a 70 to Woods' 75. Back to Saturday's final pairing, two residents of Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida, co-leaders Vijay Singh and Jim Furyk. After both setting a new 36-hole scoring mark, the pair looked to take the numbers even deeper into the U.S. Open record book. Furyk, the 10th-ranked player in the world, and Singh, already boasting 2 wins, ranked number 4 in the world. The pair knew it wasn't going to be easy, as they had already been overtaken on the leaderboard before even completing a hole. Singh, though, to retake a share of the lead at 8 under. And he ties Nick Price, who was off to that sizzling start. Now Furyk, after parring the first 4 holes, had this approach shot with a 7 iron to the 5th. Furyk would make that putt for his first birdie of the day and regain a piece of the lead himself. At the par 5 6th, this third shot from the bunker would result in Furyk's 13th birdie of the championship. Singh for his birdie at the par 5. Both men to 9 under. Furyk on the 9th, the longest par 4 at 496 yards. Furyk would make that to become just the 3rd player in U.S. Open history to reach 10 under par during the championship. Vijay Singh, however, began having problems on the back 9. A bogey at the 12th to drop out of a tie for the lead. Furyk, who had bogeyed the 10th, with this long birdie putt at the par 3 15th. On the edge of the shadows and in, back to 10 under par for Furyk and a 2-shot lead. After his 63 the day before, Vijay Singh was finding the going a little tougher today. A bogey at 16 to fall 3 behind Furyk. And then in the bunker at the par 3 17th. That would lead to another drop shot for Singh. While Furyk led the field in greens and regulation, he still made clutch par saves, like this one at 16. At 17, though, he let one slip away. back to 9-under. To the last hole, and Singh's struggles continue. It would be another long par putt for the second round co-leader. And it would be three bogeys in a row to finish for Singh, who after coming home the previous day in 29, stumbled in on Saturday with a 38. Singh's second round 63, followed by a third round 72, which left him at 5-under. Furyk for birdie at 18. And that would give him the lowest 54-hole total in U.S. Open history by three shots. 10-under par for the championship and a three-shot lead going into the final round. Furyk with three consecutive rounds in the 60s and some history on his side. The last four third-round leaders in the U.S. And anticipating the final round, the Metroline trains from downtown Chicago were full as the fans took the 45-minute ride to Olympia Fields wondering, could anyone mount a final round challenge on Jim Furyk? Tiger Woods had never won a major from any position other than the 54-hole lead. Nevertheless, 11 shots back. And history-making comebacks weren't in the cards on this Father's Day. The putter was uncooperative all week for Tiger. Among those who made the cut, he ranked fourth from last in the putting stats. Woods would finish with a final round 72, three over in defense of his championship at Bethpage. His tie for 20th was his worst U.S. Open finish in seven starts as a pro. Nick Price's attempt to emulate his lightning-fast start of the day before was unsuccessful. A missed par putt at the opening hole. Another par putt at the second. And Price would open up with three consecutive bogeys and go out in 40 for a birdie at the 15th. But Price would finish with bogeys at 17 and 18 to shoot a 75 in the final round and tie for fifth at even par. Price's playing competitor, Vijay Singh, had another tough day. A double bogey at the shortest par four, the third, to drop to 4-under, six behind Furyk. Singh recorded six consecutive bogeys at one point and had this birdie at 15 to ease some of the pain. A final round 78 for Singh to conclude his championship at plus three, tied for 20th. While some were backing up, others were making a move, including Masters champion Mike Weir. The Canadian capped off a remarkable comeback after three double bogeys in his first 28 holes of the championship. Well composed through it all,
Weir fired a final round 71 to finish at one under for the championship in a tie for third. And he would finish tied for third with Kenny Perry, who continued his stellar season. Perry, who came into this championship with two wins and two starts, fired a final round 67, the best round of the day on Sunday. One of just two amateurs to make the cut was 30-year-old Tripp Keeney from Dallas, Texas. A chip-in for eagle at the sixth. Keeney, the runner-up to Tiger in the 94 U.S. Amateur, led the field in driving distance for the week with a 325-yard average, something younger brother Hank and sister Kelly would be proud of. His par putt at the 72nd hole enabled him to finish as low amateur at 10 over. After the emotional and record-setting opening round, Bruce Edwards and Tom Watson were out of contention on Sunday. But Watson had this birdie putt at the sixth. At the 13th, Watson's 10th and final birdie of the championship. There would be no trophy for the pair on this day, as chants of Bruce, Bruce rang out from the crowd. In the minds of most, however, they were the true champions this week. Tom Watson, a final round 72, to finish at four over in a tie for 28th.
Is there one memory from this week that you'll look back on when you think about this week?
Yeah, Bruce's tears. They'll always be with me, and that's right into my heart. That, you know, what he's going through is a horrible thing, and I just I want to find something for him.
Well, Tom, you've been a champion, especially for the way that you've taken care of Bruce and pledged your support for him and all of his medical care. Thank you very much. Congratulations on a great week.
Just before he began play, an emotional hug from Jim Furyk's father, Mike, on Father's Day.
From Ponte Vedra Beach, Florida, Jim Furyk.
Furyk just 18 holes away from perhaps capturing the 103rd United States Open. He began the day with a three-shot lead and had a birdie try at the first. And Furyk was in trouble off the tee at the second. This was his third shot to the par four. And it would leave him with a long par putt. Furyk got up and down for par 8 of the 13 times through 3 rounds. And there was another. Now on the tee at the 164-yard par 3 fourth. The unorthodox swing was on the mark again. He would two-putt for par from there. After a birdie at the sixth to get to 11 under, he had another birdie try at the par 3 seventh. Furyk was staying away from bogeys, only 6 in the championship at this point, a two-putt par there. Now his approach shot from 138 yards at the par 4 ninth. Yet another green in regulation for Furyk, who held a 5-shot lead at this point over Stephen Leaney. Furyk's father has been his only coach, and his dad taught him to putt cross-handed when he was just a boy. That's because Arnold Palmer and Gary Player told him at a pro-am that if they could change one thing about their game, it would be to start putting cross-handed at an early age. And the advice certainly has helped out Jim Furyk, in position to become a U.S. Open champion. A 5-shot lead with 9 holes to play. His closest pursuer remained Leaney. After a bogey at the first, this approach shot at the second helped set up a birdie to get him back to 7 under. Now at the par 3 fourth, following another bogey, Leaney for birdie. At the sixth, Leaney for his third birdie in 6 holes. And quite a performance for Leaney in just his second U.S. Open. He missed the cut in 99 at Pinehurst. But now faced with this difficult lie from the bunker at the par 3 seventh. Leaney would make bogey, and he would have yet another par tester on the very next hole. That dropped him to 6 under. And after another bogey at 11, Leaney with a long birdie putt at 13. And he's not quite out of it. Back to 6 under and within 3 of the leader, Furyk. Only one Australian had ever won the U.S. Open, David Graham in 1981 at Marion. And as hard as the Aussie tried, Leaney struggled to keep up the pressure on Furyk. Furyk had recorded an impressive 12 top 10 finishes in 31 major starts, but his best finish was 4th. Could he close the deal at Olympia Fields with 9 to play? This for par at the 10th. And Furyk would pick up his first bogey of the day. Now for a birdie at 11. He would remain at 10 under. Another long attempt to save par at 12. Two bogeys and 3 holes now for Furyk, and he was back to 9 under. This to get one back at the next hole. Now Furyk a bit frustrated, his second shot to the par 4 14th.
Be right. Be right.
It was right. He would birdie 14 to get back to 10 under. And on the tee at 16, leading by 4. Furyk needs only to play the last 3 holes in even par to break the 72-hole U.S. Open scoring record by 2 shots. And he would have a birdie try at 16. His father, Mike, looking on, would anticipate one of the best Father's Day presents he could ever imagine. Furyk would bogey 17 and come to the 72nd hole at 9 under, still with a 4-shot lead. His approach at 18. It would be a satisfying and emotional walk-up for a man once told by a prominent college coach that he would never play major college golf,
with a swing like his. Well, that swing was about to win Jim Furyk the U.S. Open. After fighting off the tears, Furyk for birdie at 18. It would be a three-putt bogey on the 72nd hole, but with the cushion he had, it didn't matter. A final round 72, and Jim Furyk had won his major championship. He equaled the lowest 72-hole total in championship history, 272, 8 under par. And his wife, Tabitha, and 11-month-old daughter, Callie, were there to congratulate him. Furyk's first Father's Day as a dad. His mother, Linda, joined the celebration as well. And then his father, Mike.
Jim, congratulations. During the course of the round, we heard from your dad, Mike, the only coach you've ever had. What does it mean to you to not only become the U.S. Open champion, but to do it on Father's Day?
I had to open up with that one, didn't you? At least get me at the end. You know, I'm going to start crying here. It's very special. I had a difficult time actually even speaking to him this morning to wish him happy Father's Day. Just... I'm very close with my family. My wife's very close with hers, and my mom and dad are very involved in my career, in my life. It was difficult to even wish him Happy Father's Day. So I think this is a heck of a present. So Happy Father's Day.
When people talk about the best players never to win a major, it's a compliment in a sense, but it's a category you want to get into and out of quickly. Now you're out of it.
I never paid that much attention to that. I've said that in the press room the last couple of days, and it is a compliment in one sense, and I think as the years go on, I still said last night I consider myself pretty young in my career at 33. But as the years go on, I think it becomes that much tougher and that much more difficult, and you put that much more pressure on yourself. But there's a lot of great players out there that haven't won a major championship a lot, far better than I've played in my career. So it's probably an injustice to them. It's a proud day. I'm it's beyond some dreams.
It's a lot to take in, I know, but has it dawned on you that from now on, when you're introduced, it's unlikely ever again to be a very good golfer with a quirky swing? The first thing they're going to say is U.S. Open champion Jim Furyk.
It hasn't dawned on me, but I can get used to it, that's for sure. How's that?
Congratulations, Jim.
Thank you, I appreciate it.
Only four golfers finished under par. Australian Stephen Leaney had his best finish in a major. And in the end, Olympia Fields extracted some vengeance for the low scores it yielded earlier in the week. This was the culmination of a lifelong dream for Jim Furyk. Instead of imagining it, he was living it. This was the U.S. Open, and he was dealing with its pressure, handling its emotions. And on this Father's Day, this was Jim Furyk's championship, to celebrate now and forever.